And now, weather on the threes with Storm Tracker 13 meteorologist Chris Still.
Good morning to you. Welcome back. Time now is 6:13. I hope you are having a good Monday morning out there. Things looking pretty good there on our Myrtle Beach Skycam. Pretty sunrise out there this morning. Let's take a look at our Titan radar this morning. And, well, what we're seeing out there is one lone rain shower on Highway 17 in Georgetown County. That is about it. It's not going to last much longer. But we did get some rain across much of the area overnight. Northern parts of the PD, mainly inland areas, got the rain last night. It'll be mainly the beaches that get a little bit of rain later on today. Here's your tropical satellite picture over the past 12 hours. It is hurricane season. Just want to remind you of that. Nothing going on in the Gulf of Mexico. One little disturbance out there in the Atlantic Ocean, but right now it's just spinning in place, and the hurricane center is not too concerned about that one. Right now, our temperatures are in the mid-70s again this morning. Very warm and muggy. That continues to be the theme. 75 in Surfside Beach, 74 for North Myrtle. Farther inland, a little bit cooler. We have 70 for Conway and Loras, and 70s around the PD as well. 72 right now in Florence, 68 in Maxton, and a little bit of cooler air. Part of a cold front is making its way into the area. Right now, 64 the temperature in Sherrill. Our forecast today, well, for the inland areas, it's going to be another hot and dry day. Today will be the 15th consecutive day of 90-plus weather, about 93 your high inland, upper 80s at the beach. Our cold front is stalled right along the coast, and that will be where there could be a 30% chance of thunderstorms, mainly out there this afternoon. It's not going to be a whole lot in the way of rain. In fact, the Hair Day forecast today, well, this will be close to the coast. We'll call it a 3 out of 5, 3.5 out of 5 there in Conway. Farther inland, maybe a 4.5 out of 5 without the rain in the forecast, but we're still going to have a good bit of humidity and a lot of hot weather. Wind really not a factor out there today. Here's your forecast tracker as we head through the next few days. We have our cold front, but this time of the year, they don't come blazing through here and cool us off like they do in the wintertime. They usually stall right here across the Carolinas, and that's what's going on out there today. And that will keep that 30% chance of rain in the forecast through the afternoon and early evening hours tonight. This is 3 o'clock. Notice west of I-95, really nothing in the way of rain. East of I-95, I can't guarantee there won't be a thunderstorm. 7 o'clock tonight, close to the coast, there could be a shower or two. But again, the rule of thumb today, the farther you live away from the coast, the farther away those rain chances are going to stay. Now, looking ahead to the rest of the week, well, tomorrow will be a cooler, mainly dry day between cold fronts. Throw in a 20% chance of showers. That's a little too close to comfort there. But our next rain chance, for the most part, after today will occur around midweek. In fact, Wednesday night and especially on Thursday appears to be the best chance of rain as that cold front moves into the area. And that one, too, may stall and keep a chance of rain in the forecast on Friday, maybe even Saturday as well. Today's forecast, partly sunny, a hot day for the inland areas. 93 your high today in King Street, 90 for Murrells Inlet, 93 today in Hartsville. Again, probably no rain today in Hartsville, just a lot of sunny and hot weather. Closer to the coast in Conway, 93 your high, 30% chance of rain, and we'll take that on down to the coast with 90 the high today in Litchfield, 69 tonight in Florence, and 66 your low tonight in Conway. Again, there could be a shower or two early tonight close to the coast, with a low near 70 in Murrells Inlet. Here comes your 7-day forecast for the Grand Strand. The cold front that has stalled on top of us eventually gets through here by tomorrow and cools us off a little bit for the middle part of the week. Highs in the low to mid 80s by Wednesday and Thursday. Inland areas, well, today is day number 15 with the hot weather, but we'll break the streak tomorrow. In fact, highs only in the mid 80s by Wednesday and Thursday.